Hello friends, today we are going to see the numericals based on minimum number of teeth on pinion and wheel in order to avoid interference. So see, this is problem. Okay, in previous video we already seen the problems on the based on what number of teeth on pinion and wheel in order to avoid the interference. So similar problem will be there, only cases will be different. That means here case will be different. We are going to see the number of problems as case to case. Okay, so see here, a pair of spur gear with involute teeth is to give a gear ratio of 4:1. The arc of approach is not to be less than the circular pitch and smaller wheel is the driver. The angle of pressure is 14.5 degree. Find the first finding, the least number of teeth that can be used on each wheel. And second, the addendum of the wheel in terms of circular pitch. So, see here, a pair of spur gear is with involute teeth is to give a gear ratio 4:1. That means gear ratio G is equal to 4. That means gear ratio G is equal to capital T divided by small t is equal to capital R divided by small r is equal to 4. Okay, the arc of approach is not to be less than the circular pitch. That means the arc of approach is not to be less than circular pitch. That means it is equal to what? Circular pitch. Okay, now next is what? Smaller wheel is the driver. Now see here, the smaller wheel is what? Driver. Okay, the angle of pressure is 14.5 degree. Now here angle of pressure, that is phi is given, that is 14.5 degree. Find, that is first finding is that the least number of teeth that can be used on each wheel, that is what? Minimum number of teeth that can be used on each wheel. And second finding is that the addendum of the wheel in terms of circular pitch, that is what? In terms of that, they want to find, they want addendum in terms of circular pitch. That means addendum is equal to some value into circular pitch, that is PC will be there. Okay, now see here, write down whatever data is given in this problem. So given, that is G is equal to what? Gear ratio is given, that is what? 4. Okay, gear ratio is 4. The gear ratio is nothing but what? Capital T divided by small t or capital R divided by small r. Again, what is given? Phi is equal to what? 14.5 degrees. Okay, now solve this problem one by one. First finding is that least number of teeth on each wheel. Okay, we know that the maximum length of arc of approach is equal to the arc of approach. This is totally depend on path of approach. So arc of approach is nothing but what? Length of approach divided by cos of phi. Now what they want here? The maximum length of approach. Now maximum length of approach, this is nothing but what? It is the ratio of maximum length of path of approach divided by cos of phi. Okay, now length of path of approach maximum, that is what? Small r into sine of phi divided by this cos of phi. So see here, r will be the, here see here, sine of phi divided by cos of phi. So we know that sine divided by cos is equal to tan. So here the maximum length of arc of approach is equal to r into this r into tan of phi. Now next is what? Circular pitch. The circular pitch is equal to, we know that this is nothing but what? Pi into m, that is what? Module. Okay, now this is what? PC is equal to 2 pi r divided by t. Now see here, since the arc of approach is not to be less than the circular pitch, in problem what they are given, they are stated like that the arc of approach is not to be less than pitch. That means both are the, we are taking here the arc of approach is equal to circular pitch. Okay, now circular pitch is equal to what? 2 pi r divided by t. Okay, now maximum arc of this approach is equal to r into tan of phi. Therefore r into tan of phi is equal to 2 pi r divided by t. This equation will be here. Okay, now next, therefore from this equation we can also write here, this t will be here, t is equal to, that is number of teeth, okay, is equal to this 2 pi r divided by tan of phi. I write down here, okay, only t will be here and this r into tan of phi will be here, okay. Now see here, this t is equal to 2 pi here, okay. Now here this r, suppose r will be here, this r r will cancel here, so t is equal to what remains here, 2 pi divided by tan of phi. So 2 is constant, again pi is constant, this is having the value, that is 3.142 divided by tan of phi. The value of phi is given in the problem, that is 14.5 degree. So put the values here, okay, put the values in calculate this term. We got here this t is equal to 24.3. the value we got of t is equal to 24.3. now t may not be in points, okay, the t will be, number of t's will be the whole number, that is what, therefore small t, that is t's on the pinion, that is what, 25, number of t's is a what, 25, okay. Now we already we in this problem we got here what, t, okay. Now next is what, capital T. In the first finding is that they asked what, number of teeth on the both wheels, that is what, number of teeth on pinion and number of teeth on the wheel, okay. Now we got here number small t, that is what, number of teeth on the pinion, okay. Now next is finding is that number of teeth on wheel. So we know that the capital T divided by small t is equal to what, gear ratio G. In problem the gear ratio G is given, okay. So here we already got the value of t, so we from these two we got, we will find the value of this capital T. So capital T, that is what, number of teeth on wheel is equal to G into small t. So G is what, 4, given in problem. We got here 25, this is small t. So we got here capital T is equal to 100. So this is what, nothing but what, number of teeth on wheel is equal to 100. Now next finding is that, second finding, they ask that addendum on wheel in terms of circular pitch, okay. Now we know that the addendum, the formula to find out the addendum on wheel, that is what, addendum on wheel is equal to m into capital T divided by 2 in bracket under root 1 plus this small t divided by capital T into bracket small t divided by capital T plus 2 into sin square of phi minus 1, okay. So put the values, we have the values of small m, okay, we have the value of capital T, again we have the value of phi. So put the values we got here, addendum, okay. So see here, m into 100 divided by 2 into bracket 1 plus this 25, this is what small t, again this 100 is what, capital T. This will be 25 divided by 100 into bracket 25 divided by 100 plus 2 into sin square of 14.5 degree minus 1, okay. Now put as it is this m, okay, 20 m into this 0.017 is equal to, that means this whole value into this multiplication 100, okay, the value comes here, okay. So sorry, see here, this 100 divided by 2, that means 50 will be here, okay, this m will be as it is, okay. Now this whole terms become 0.017, okay. So multiply here, we got here 0.85 m. so value is what, 0.85 m. why we are taken here m as it is, so we have to find out the addendum in terms of circular pitch, okay. Now here is what, 0.85 m, okay, 0.85 m. now again we know that circular pitch PC is equal to, I will write here the PC, that PC is equal to pi into m, okay. Now here m term will be here, we want to find out in terms of PC, so write down here m is equal to PC divided by pi, okay, this PC divided by pi will be here, okay, this m is equal to PC divided by pi. Put this value here, okay. Now what we got here, 0.85 into PC divided by pi, again pi will be the constant, that is 3.142. put the value of pi, that is 3.142. so what we got here is equal to 0.27 times PC, that means addendum is equal to, addendum of wheel is equal to 0.2 point times of PC. This is our final finding. Okay, that means in problem number 1 we already find out the whatever they asked, we already find out here. Okay, now we are moving moving towards the next problem. That is what? Problem number 4. Okay, in previous videos we seen that problem number 1, 2. Now here problem number 3 will be this, and now we are moving towards the problem number 4. Okay, so see here, problem number 4 will be here. 2 20 degree involute spur gears having a module of 10 mm. 2 20 degree spur gears have a module of 10 mm. The addendum is 1 module. Okay, the addendum is equal to what? 1 module. The larger gear has 50 teeth and the pinion has 13 teeth. Okay, so see here, I will read whole problem. The 2 20 degree involute spur gears have a module of 10 mm. The addendum is 1 module. The larger gear has 50 teeth and pinion has 13 teeth. Does interference occur? If it is occurs, to what value should be the pressure angle to be changed to eliminate interference? That means in this problem, what they want to ask, or what they ask, that is it interference is occur? That means interference is occur or not. If occurs, then how to eliminate the interference? That means we have to avoid the interference by changing the pressure angle. Okay, so first thing is that what is given in this problem, the given data, that is what? Angle phi is equal to what? 20 degree. Next is what? Module is equal to what? 10 mm. The addendum is equal to 1 module, that is not addendum is equal to 10 mm. The larger gear has 50 teeth, that means capital T is equal to what? 50 teeth. And small pinion has 13 teeth, that is what? Small t is equal to 13 teeth. Okay, does interference occur? We have to find out the interference occur or not, and if occurs, then what should be the value of pressure angle to be changed to eliminate the interference? So see here, first thing is that write down data, that is phi is equal to what? 20 degree. Again capital T is equal to 50. Next m is equal to what? 10. Again small t is equal to 13. Addendum is equal to what? 1 module is equal to, put the value of module, that is what? 10 mm. So addendum is equal to what? 10 mm. Now see here, the capital R is equal to, we know that capital R is equal to m into capital T divided by 2. So put the value of capital T, that is what? R is equal to 10 into 50 divided by 2. So we got here capital R is equal to what? 250 mm. Now next is what? Next finding is what? Capital RA. Okay, A stands for addendum, the radius of addendum of the field, that is what? Small RA. So how to find out the small RA? This R plus addendum, the capital R, the we have the value of the capital R, that is what? 250, plus we have the value of addendum, that is what? 10. So 250 plus 10, we got here 260 mm. This is nothing but what? Capital RA. Now next finding is what? Small r. Now small r is equal to what? M into t divided by 2. This t will become small t will be there. Okay, now m will be 10. Okay, small t will be 13 divided by 2. So by calculation we got here this r is equal to 65 mm. This is what? Radius of p circle of the pinion. Now we have to find out the maximum addendum radius. We have to find out the maximum addendum radius, and this can be find out by using the relation. The relation will be like that. See here, this relation, RA max is equal to R into under root 1 plus T divided by T, that is small t divided by capital T into bracket, this small t divided by capital T into this 2 plus 2 into sine square of phi. Okay, now see here, we have the value of this capital R, that is what? 250. Next we have the value of this small t, that is 13. Okay, we have the value of this capital T, that is 15, into bracket this 13 divided by 50 plus 2 into sine square of phi. Okay, this put as it is, this sine square of phi, because we have to find out the pressure angle, or we have to put here value of phi, that is whatever given in problem, and find out this RA max. Okay, afterwards we are going to find out the value of this phi. Okay, the actual addendum radius is more than the value of RA max, therefore interference is occur. Okay, that means if you find out the value here, So what we got value here, put this value of 5, that is what given is 20. So we got RA max is equal to 258.45 mm, and in actual one we got here value that is 258.45 mm. This is what the maximum addendum, and in problem actual addendum will be what is what 260. That means this 260 will be more, okay, rather than this one. So from this statement we can state it that the actual addendum radius RA is more than the maximum value of RA max, okay, therefore the interference occurs. That means here interference will be occur, okay. So how to avoid the interference? We have to increase the pressure angle, okay. Now we have to find out the pressure angle, at what pressure angle the interference will be avoided. Now see here, we are going to find out the new value of pressure angle, that is phi, that is by taking the RA max equal to RA. Now see here, we are taking RA max is equal to RA. Now put here, same formula will be there in previous one. See here, the same formula we are going to use. Instead of this RA max, we are going to use RA. Okay. Now see here, the formula is what? R is RA max is equal to RA is equal to under root 250 cos of phi bracket square plus 315 sin of phi bracket square. Okay. Now see here, this is 260 square is equal to 250 square into cos square of phi plus 315 square into bracket 1 minus cos square of phi. Instead of sin square of phi, we can write down here 1 minus cos square of phi. This is what formula, conversion formula will be there, or we can also set that double angle formula, or this sin to cos formula, factorization formula will be there. Okay. Now see here, 260 square is equal to 250 square into cos square of phi, again 315 square minus 315 square minus into cos square of phi. That means see here, this 315 square into this 1 minus cos square of phi. So multiply this 315 into this 1, again this 315 square into this cos square of phi. So we got here this equation. Okay. So instead see here, from this term get common this cos square of phi. This cos square of phi is equal to 315 square minus 260 square divided by 315 square minus 250 square. From this put the values in calci, that means rearrangement will be there. Okay, put this value in calci. So we got here cos square of phi is equal to 0.861. Okay, this is value of cos square of phi. We have to find out the value of this phi, that is what pressure angle. Okay, so what we got here, cos square of phi, take square root of this value, that means cos of phi is equal to 0.928. okay, from this is what value of this cos phi. We have to find out the phi. The phi is nothing but what, now we have to take here cos inverse of whatever constant term will be there. Okay, so see here cos of phi is equal to 0.928, or simply we can write down phi is equal to cos inverse of 0.928. by calculation, put this value in calci, by calculation we got here phi is equal to what, 21.88 degree, or simply in minutes 21 degree 52 minutes. Okay, though in previous one what is the value of phi, that is 20 degree, and here to avoid the interference what we got value here, 21.88 degree or 21 degree 52 seconds. Thus if the pressure angle is increased to 21 degree 52 seconds, the interference is avoided. That means this is a condition that is to avoid the interference. Okay, that is the condition to avoid the interference. We have seen that to avoid the interference, we can increase the number of teeth on the pinion or wheel. Okay, and second condition is that we have to increase the pressure angle. Okay, or we can vary the pressure angle. In this case, we varied the pressure angle. In previous one, that is in given, that is phi is equal to 20 degree, and by using this formula, that is phi is equal to 20 degree, we got here the interference is occur. That we have to remove the interference. We find out the new value of this phi, that is new value is what, 21.52 second, this is what? This is pressure angle, and by using this pressure angle, interference is avoided. Okay, so this problem will be somewhat different from previous one. Okay, so in next video we will see the another one problem with different cases. Okay.